Hello again and good morning, dear fellow well-being enthusiasts. This is Horia, your host for the Wellbeing Enthusiast podcast. Today I have the pleasure to invite again back to us Marius Ungureanu, who provided a very, very nice, truly amazing seminar about the Chinese metaphysics a few weeks ago. I'm sure you all loved the learnings and the attitude that he brought to us, the energy and the passion. Welcome, Marius, to our podcast. How are you doing today?
Hello, and I'm very happy to be back, and I can't wait to speak again about some, let's say, secrets about the Chinese metaphysics. In fact, they are not secrets, just because we don't pay attention to environment. So I'm happy to be here again.
Excellent. Thank you so much for accepting our invitation. It was very passionate indeed, your presentation, with a lot of personal experiences and personal stories. I'm sure most of us could relate at a certain point with your stories, because we've all been in the same situation at a certain time of trying to figure out a place where to stay at home, being in a relationship that sometimes it doesn't work fine. In your opinion, what would be the three most important ideas, the three key takeaways that somebody who wasn't able to participate in that seminar could take it for them?
I think first thing is very important to know what you want, because most of the time we live other people's lives. We compare our lives with other people, because I see this guy, he's got a beautiful relationship, maybe he's got a good business, and I want the same thing. But in fact, I want, or just I want to copy him. And the first thing is very important to know what you want, because we are so different, everybody. Not even twins are the same. So this is the first step, to know what you want. After that, this is like, it's like instruction manual for the car, to know what your options are. After that is very important, the house where you live, because the house, in fact, we are part from the house. We are part from that house. It's very, very important when we choose our house to see the environment. This is first step to see. Because from this environment, we can decide if we can have a good relationship, if we can have a good career, and so on. So this is first step. I know it's very difficult to choose a house without to know some stuff from metaphysics, but actually it's very easy. And first you have to like what you see. Usually, for example, it's not good to choose a house where is industrial area, for example. Mm-hmm. It's very important. It's very important like your house to be like, to have like embracement, it's like a chair to embrace you from the building to right and left and the back. But this is just to see without to know anything. Just this is first step to see your house. And another thing is very, very important, the main door. The main door is the most important thing from the house, the main door.
It's the like entrance.
The entrance is very, very important. It's like, you see, sometimes I've seen, including in Bucharest, we see some malls with a very big building with a small entrance door.
Exactly.
It's like you see like a big guy with a small mouth. It's the same. We have to see to make this difference between like a building and a man. So this is very important when you build a house to be very careful with the door, because that it's 80% from the house, the energy. Because the energy enters that door. Because
80%.
Yes.
That's powerful. Yeah. The main entrance.
Yeah, the main entrance, yeah. I've seen some business the building was so bad. And I just changed the door. This is the only thing I done. I just changed the door. Imagine if you cover your mouth, you cannot eat. And of course you'll die. The same with the house. This was the biggest problem in my house, the main door.
That's so after brilliant.
I, Yeah, yes. Because after I clean everything inside, because everything was like a lot of stuff was like I declutter.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
After that, everything was smoothly. Yeah, it was so easy. I mean, within 6 or 7 months, I could move in the house. And for me, I was shocked because I say it's impossible to be that simple, but trust me, it is. And you don't have to believe, just do it, because this Chinese metaphysics is not a religion, it's a science. Just do it and it's working.
It's pure science. That's brilliant. Speaking of homes, you know that we as a Romanian people, we love to be owners, to be the owners of our own homes, even if they are apartments, pretty crowded, small, in crowded areas. What can we do specifically? Most people, okay, they apply for a credit to get the home of their dreams, and they probably don't really pay attention to these aspects, as you mentioned, you know, the entrance and the positioning of the house. Just they probably, this is the house that they afford, they pay for it, probably even if they're not 100% sure that that's the proper one for them. What can they do further on if the entrance it's not good according to the Chinese metaphysics?
In my opinion, in this situation is much better to rent than to own a house, because it's so easy to change. For example, I have to change my house this year. Mm-hmm. So I'm not sure how easy I'm going to sell this house, you see, but if it was a renting house, I would just move. So, you know, to change your house is like a step by step you take. So first thing I think is better to rent a house in order to achieve what you want. And after that, you go to the next step. And of course, sometimes maybe you cannot afford to rent a very, very good house, but you don't need a very, very good house. You just to be better than the previous one. The better. Now, of course, you need somebody to show you, to tell you about that house, because it's almost impossible on this level to know if it's good or bad, that house. It's almost impossible, but it's better, it's much, much easier now to rent than to buy. And of course, after you have this information, of course you can buy, but it's difficult. Imagine if you buy a house now, and after somebody, a consultant coming to your house and they say, no, this house is not good for relationship, what you are doing? It's almost impossible. No, it's shocking to sell the house. You just bought that house.
Exactly.
So it's better now to rent, because after I will sell this house, I will rent, I will not buy. Mm-hmm. Because I have to stay 1 year to take maximum from that house and go to the next one. Because I know in Romania we are educated to own, to be an owner, to own the house. But yeah, in my opinion, it's a mistake. Of course, after, I don't know, maybe after 40 years old, after 40 years, you can buy a house. But until then, you just have to try. Because I think it's almost impossible to find the best house right now. Because if we watch on Bucharest, all the construction are so badly done. So it's, you know, 90, I think from every cases I done, more than 90% they have relationships problems.
Really?
Yeah.
And 90%.
That's possible.
That's a huge number, yeah.
Yeah, it's a huge, trust me. It's almost more than 90%, trust me. It's shocking for me. And I say, no, I watch the construction. This has happened more just in Bucharest. I've seen this just in Bucharest. If you see the new developer now, how they build a house, they don't care.
They don't care of anything.
Of course, most of the people they buy because the houses are cheap. Around the Bucharest, of course, it's, I don't know, maybe 75,000, 80,000 euro, maybe a house of homeland with like, I don't know, 3 bedrooms and stuff like that. And they don't care, they buy a price. They don't buy a house. This is the difference. And of course, when you say no, Marius, you say, okay, this house is not good for what you're looking for. And say, you know, Marius, this is what I afford now. And sometimes you cannot fix. Not every house can be fixed. It's not.
You mentioned earlier about what you can take. What do you mean specifically what you can take from the house? The energy or what?
Yes, it's like the energy. For example, in my house, I will take this house because it's the best example. This one was not good for relationships. It was very good to meet teachers in this house.
To meet teachers?
Yeah.
But not good for relationships. All right.
For relationships. But I say, okay, you cannot have everything in this house. So I say, I will take step by step. All first right. thing I have to, because I love so much what I'm doing, I say, I have to take everything from this house. And I went to study with every master I want to, because it was possible. This energy helped me to achieve that, what I want. But now it's almost done. I feel that it's, I cannot take any more from this house. So the decision is to stay on this level and to go, or to go higher. And I want to go higher. So in this moment, I want to sell. This is, doesn't mean this is a bad house. For somebody, it can be good. Maybe somebody say, you know what? I don't want to learn nothing. For me, it's okay to go to a job from 9 to 5. It's okay. It's done. It's okay for me. I have already a family. I don't care anymore about nothing. So it's good. But for me, it's not anymore. So that's why when you go, for example, all the time you have to have a purpose when you go, what you want from that house. This is the question. Because when you say a good or bad feng shui, what is good, what is bad? This is, you have to tell me what is good, what you want. So if you say, if you tell me, you know, Marius, from this house, I want to, I don't know, to have a good relationship. Okay, let's see. I will not tell you if the house is good or bad. I will tell you what provides you that house, and you will decide if it's good or bad, because what you know what you want. For me, it's almost impossible to feel what you feel. So this is, I have to decode, let's say decode that house and say, okay, Horia, this house gives you this and that, and so, and you'll say, okay, Marius, for me, it's okay. But after a few years, say it will change. Maybe it's possible to something will change, but you have the information and you know what to expect. You move or you stay there. You don't have to move. You can stay there, but you know what happened in this house. Maybe this is the maximum what you achieve in this house. This is, when you say you take everything from the house.
Yeah, this is very interesting, which leads me to this question. What if, yeah, probably most people, once they've purchased a house, they probably wouldn't like to move, even if probably things are not going very well. As you said, they might end up in a bad relationship, or they might end up being sick for whatever reason. As I also, I've started researching on Feng Shui, and also read that book from Lilian too, about probably, you know, people having relationship and also health problems in various homes. And once, only once they've managed to move away from that house, things started to work better for them. What if you, you tell the, to tell these people, look, you have this, this and this problems over here. The most, the best choice for you will be to move. And they said, no, we don't really don't want to move. We want to stay here. Are there any solutions to do to make any changes in the house? I don't know, make some refurbishments, move the furniture. Yes, I don't know, yes, things like this. Yes. So I, there I are choices.
Yes, of course, I'll tell them to move. Actually, I tell them it's good for them to move after I do this assessment to the house, and I see what I can do from, because sometimes, many times actually I can fix many times, but sometimes I cannot fix sometimes. And when I see I cannot fix, then I tell you, no, it's better for you to move. And they say, you know what? I don't want to move. It's okay. That means you accept your life and your condition. It's, it for me is fine. Accept your destiny and you're done. Because that is your free will. Yeah, that is your free will. I give you the information. You do what you want to do with that information. But of course, that's why when somebody called me, say, Marius, I want to do a project to my house, you can do it. I say, no, I don't know. I have to see it first, to see what I can do for you. And I will tell you then. You don't have to move. I tell you, you see, this is the maximum from that house. Because sometimes, like I say, Horia, if you just bought this house, and I tell you, no, you have to move. Imagine how you live in that house. To know you have to move. So I don't tell you like that, you have to move. But I tell you, no, this house, this is maximum what you can achieve from this house. This information helps you because sometimes when something is wrong in the, I don't know, maybe in relationship, maybe with your career, some stuff like that, we try to blame somebody.
Exactly, maybe, yeah.
Your wife, maybe your girlfriend, maybe your friend, or maybe your kids, I don't know. But if you have this information, you say, you know what? I know, guys, it's not your fault. We are together in this stuff. So let's try to have to make a plan. We stay here and we go together to this storm, because maybe just a period is not all life. Or maybe we try to make a plan to move from this house. Maybe sometimes, you know, sometimes you have to, for example, let's say this house, for example, on this house, I have one, I have two main doors on this house. And one of the main doors this year has got the worst energy possible, the worst. For me, luckily, I have two entrances, main doors. But let's take an example. I have just one. For me, in that year, it's good to not live in that house, because I cannot enter through the window on my house. You understand? So you don't have to sell this house for 1 year. I can move for 1 year to stay in rent, to rent an apartment and come back after that.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why you give them the information. But, you know, we live to we have this attachment all the time. We don't want to sell. We don't have to move. But we are the center of everything. Even if you rent a house, it's still your energy in that house. Within 3 months, your energy is moving to that house. Because if you move, for example, from a house to an apartment, doesn't mean your life will change next day. You need the time. This feng shui is working slow, but it's working. And for a long
slow time. Slow, steady.
Yeah. So you have to be patient. But that's why you have to know what you want, and you need this feng shui imply action. Without action, feng shui is zero. It's not because we are, I've seen this, you know.
What kind of actions? What kind of action can you take? Okay, you need to know what you want. And yeah, what specific actions?
For example, I spoke with somebody, a couple, and she told me, for example, you know, I'm not happy with my boyfriend. And first thing, you know, you think, what is the problem in these relationships? Because there are so many problems. I say, why you are not happy with your boyfriend?
Mm-hmm.
And she told me, you know, I want to go more in more vacations, and we don't go. We stay home all the time. So, okay, I spoke with this guy. Why don't go on vacation with your girlfriend? Because I don't have money for that. Okay, why don't have money? Because my job is not so good. They pay me so less. Okay, I say, that means you have to change. We have to work to change your job in order to have money to go on vacation and to be happy. You see, from this problem to relationship, we go to his job. And we work. We do this feng shui for him to go to change his job, but his action, he has to apply in order to change. Because if he's going to the same job without to do anything, nothing will change. I say, okay, this feng shui provides you this opportunity, but you have to take action. What action? Apply. Speak with your friends. You know, guys, I want to change my job. If you hear somebody needs my skills or stuff like that. And after that, you change your job, you have money, you go to vacation, you'll be happy. You see, from a problem, where you go. This is the action when you have to take. This is doesn't mean for me, if I'm stubborn and I have to work to have a very good house for a relationship and I don't change this stuff for me, of course, doesn't mean the house will do everything for me. The house provides you that energy to help you to achieve that much easier. But
obviously action, you need to know how to channel that energy. It's not just it's there. You just need to
in the house, actually, it's like Wi-Fi signal, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So you don't have signal, you know, you go with your phone.
Exactly.
The same here. You have to know, you know, when you go home and you're hungry, you have to go to the kitchen, you want to sleep, you go to the bedroom. The same is with the feng shui. You have to see, to find that energy. What is for the business? What is for the relationship? What is the best energy for the relationship? You have to place the bedroom there. What is the best energy for the business? You have to place your desk there. This is just to place the desk there. Because including you now, Horia, you have a feng shui to your home. Just you don't know what you did there. You use your intuition. You know, I like the couch here, I like this here, and so on. But with this feng shui, try to personalize this according to your birthday. We do that natal chart and we try to see how you fix your feng shui with your energy, your house with your energy.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
I've taken that chart and I'm applying it. Now I'm standing at my desk facing north, because according to the chart, north is my positive. Mm-hmm. So over the next 2 months, is my, and I'm carrying also this little frog over here with coins sitting next to me here. With the face of the frog, I don't know, facing southwest, because I don't know, something that the feng shui chart suggested. So yeah, I'm just doing it. I'm taking action on this. Brilliant. So let's move now further on to another topic that really it was very interesting and challenging as well, about the face and how you could identify a certain background of a person according to their face.
You know,
tell us a little bit about this. How important is the mouth and the cheeks of somebody's face?
Yes. First thing, the feng shui of the house is your own face, our face.
Hmm.
Because you have in your face your cardinal points. You have the south, you have the north, we have the east, west, and the center of the house.
Mm-hmm.
When, for example, when you apply to a job, for example, it's very, very important to see if you have that skills. You know, for example, this part of the nose is the wealth palace.
All right.
The lips is very good when you lead a team, maybe when you when you sell something, when you are front office and you talk to the people, it's very, you have to see the mouth. When you work to the computer, for example, a lot, your eyes is very important, and so on. When depends, because you know there is no a bad face, there is no bad face. In the past, this we used this natal charts to hire people to go behind the resume. But now we use also the face. Of course, it's a little bit harder for the ladies when they have the plastic surgery, but okay, we can work with that too.
So it's useful to have the photo on the CV, on the resume, when you know people are submitting their resumes, it's good to have their photo there. Is it useful for somebody like you to not only read what that person has done in their career, but also see their picture? Here's applying for a sales job and he's having that mouth, so it's going to be a good fit.
Yeah, usually I go to the HR department, calls me after they finish this, these procedures, and just to take a look. I stay there and just to see these guys and just stay in the natal chart and to see his face. And in the end, I just give them a few lines. Okay, this guy's got these skills or not, and you decide which part of the company it's good for. So, but again, usually we know how to do that because it's inside us, but we don't have this. We do not know for what part of the company. For example, if you to see somebody say, "What happened to you?" You see him upset. You see his skin, you see his eyes, you see his lips, but in Chinese metaphysics, you know what happened there. When you see these eyes, you see he's got some relationship problems. Yeah, when you see this part of the nose, you know he's got some wealth problems, and so on. This one, the eyebrows, that means if he's team player, for example, you know, he can work with teams and stuff like that. And if you have this information, it's much easier for you, including with your girlfriend, you know, because what we do wrong, we try to change the other person. We try to change. We don't understand.
Mm-hmm.
We have to understand. Maybe sometimes it's impulsive. Maybe sometimes it's stubborn. It's okay. It's fine with that. Give him that space in that moment and it will be okay. But we try to change. The same with the people. If we see the face, you see, Horia, you have this bump here, if you see on your face, that means, you know, in China, mm-hmm. that means sometimes you can be impulsive, but you have a good intuition. In China, it's a condition in Asia to have this. You see, I have the same. In Asia, it's a condition to have this in order to achieve some a level to Chinese metaphysics. You see, this is like a pencil. You can write something nice on something or something very ugly. Depends on you. This is a quality. But sometimes we cannot control this. We become very impulsive. But it's okay. It's fine. That it's okay. We are not perfect. You see, you have this line here also. That means you are very creative. It's like artistic. Like, yeah. You see, just watching these two features and you know some stuff, you know. Again, you have this. This is Tribal Palace. You see here. You have also. That means for you it's very good to don't stay 8 hours in behind the desk. You have to travel to go from there to there. It's not good to keep you inside 8, 9, 10 hours a day.
From my desk to the kitchen and the back.
Now I know.
And working from home, yeah.
So you see, you have this. If you know this, you know you. And somebody say, okay, Horia, you have these qualities for you. I can use these qualities for you, do natural, for you, it's good. You like to do this. So when you do what you like, you don't feel like you're working. And this is, I think this is the secret. It's the secret. Do what you like and you don't feel like you work.
That's really powerful. Yeah, I love this thing. Yeah, do what you like and you're not working. Yes, this is what you are doing right now. So it's also a bit of work, of course, for both of us, but it's also something that we love, we both love. So yeah, it's, thank you so much for making this profile. I was looking forward to know more about what's...
That is qualities, trust me. That is qualities. And you have qualities. Also a small line here. Yeah, you see?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that means you are very curious to know everything.
Really?
When you see somebody, that guy have to explain you why. That is the biggest question. Why? Why? Why?
I always start with why, exactly.
Yeah, you see?
This is whenever my wives want to do something, why? Why are we doing this? See, my boss asked me something, why? Why? Always start with why.
And you see, when somebody's okay, you see Horia, when you meet this guy, you have to tell me all the time why. Explain to him, because he has to know. You see, this is also a strategy. Imagine when you meet somebody to have to negotiate something, to know all these features, you know how to speak, to approach.
So it's a valuable quality, you would say, right?
Oh, yeah. Sometimes it's like sales techniques, you know. You know how to be on
As a matter of fact, I think we are all in sales. Whatever we do, we sell something. Either we sell an idea, we sell a product, we sell a service. We just want to promote. We promote ourselves, we promote our products, our companies. So it's always good to know these aspects, definitely.
Even if you don't sell and you speak with your friend, if you understand his face, your girlfriend, you know how to talk to them. Because I think, and of course I did these mistakes, I tried to change. I thought maybe if I know so many, I have so many information, I can change to make that person next to me to see like me. That was a mistake. No, try to understand him. We cannot have to love the same color. We don't love the same car. We don't love the same woman or the same guy. So we have to understand we are different. I think this is the most important thing. And if we do that, that means I respect that kind of energy, because we are an energy, then it will be fine.
When was your aha moment when you realized this? Because obviously we've all been through this, trying to convince somebody else and from our own perspective. And at a certain time, it's with a trail and error, right?
Yeah, I have to suffer, because all the time you have to suffer to understand some stuff. I have to suffer. That was starting in 2011 when I started to understand this stuff.
So 10 years ago, well.
I didn't believe first when I heard about this Chinese metaphysics. I didn't believe. I said, no, it's impossible. For me, I have to prove me that it's working.
Really?
Yeah. Because you have to prove. You know, I work, in the past, I work in the casinos with a lot of numbers. And for me, you have to prove me. Show me. I don't believe.
Show me,
in, you know,
show me the money. Yeah.
Show me.
Of course.
Show me it's working. Prove me. And I stay 1 year to look a lot of info and to check by myself to see if it's okay, this information. I say, you know what? I have nothing to lose, just to try. And when I try and I say it's working, I say, wow, it's amazing. It cannot be that easy. You cannot,
it's powerful, huh?
declutter inside of the main door and you can move it within 7 months. It's impossible, because I'm expecting to be harder, to be, I don't know, to work a lot for this. I said, no, it's impossible. And after that, I've seen this to my friends, and I see to other people, I say, wow, there is a pattern to this. So I want to go deeper and deeper and deeper. And I start from there. And after that, it became a very big passion for me. That's why some of my friends ask me, Marius, you working in weekend? No, I don't work at all. I do what I'd like to do. For me, for example, it's a space in the, I don't know, a restaurant in Bucharest, and was three owners there. They couldn't do the business to do money. I say, okay, for me it's a challenge. I want to go to see what happened there, and I went this last Sunday. So last Sunday I went there to see. I say, Maurice, but it's Sunday. It's okay for me. It's a passion. I go to see what happened there. You know, and I've seen that. So for me, I took notice. Okay, it's working. We have this problem, and from the main entrance again. See, it's so simple, but we don't believe. And I say, okay, don't have to believe, just try, and you will see. So that's, I start from 2011, and I will not stop in this life.
And you've traveled to Asia, right? Several times to China, taking classes and learning from the masters from there.
Yes, from I study so far, I think 5 or 6 masters so far. And the last time when I went in 2019, because last year was with up, and I studied with one master one-to-one. Told me to study one-to-one. It was amazing. You see them so simple. They're so simple, you know, like a white t-shirt and stay like that in outside and just tell a few words and wow, it's amazing. You know, it's like just in the movies. And for me, it's an honor to study with these guys. So I can't wait to go back. I don't know if this year, maybe next year, I'm not sure to see what happened in this pandemic. But again, everybody will have access to this info and we can do it. We have nothing to lose.
So information is available out there for all of us. We just need to take it and use it on our own lives.
There is no, somebody asked me, Marius, which one is the best Feng Shui book? There is not such a book. Read every book, because you have to read a good and a bad book to know to make the difference. How you know the difference if you don't read a bad book? I have a very, I will tell you, I don't know, I have a Feng Shui. I think my first, I'm not sure, they say Feng Shui for dummies. You know,
yeah.
This is my first Feng Shui book. Trust me, Horia is very good at book.
Uh-huh.
When I bought that book, I think 8 years ago, somebody asked me, Marius, how you read this book? Why, you are a Feng Shui master? I'm not. It's okay, just the title. I don't care. You see that ego? Why you read this book Feng Shui for Dummies? Yeah,
it's basic.
Yeah,
it's basic information. It's always something to learn from any experience.
That book is very good. It's very, very good, that book. Ignore the title.
It lays down the foundations.
Take book by book, try a lot of stuff. You see what is working, what is not working, because there are so many schools. Because these masters, this Feng Shui was just for the imperial court. It's not for the ordinary people.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it was not for the, actually the Feng Shui was for the dead people, not for the living one in the past. That was the Feng Shui, yeah, more than 6,000 years ago. And I tell them, okay, you have to try to see what is working, because there are so many schools in Feng Shui now. So the question is, which one is better?
Mm-hmm.
The school with the technique, if it's working, that is the best one. So you have to try many techniques in order to see which one is working. I did that. Some techniques didn't work, some did. So I did the difference. That's why I read the good books and bad books. So that's why I say read everything and you'll see you make the difference. You'll have a picture.
Based on your experience and the knowledge that you've achieved so far, are you planning to open up your own school of Feng Shui here in Bucharest, in Romania?
100%, yeah, 100%.
Excellent.
I want to do something like I want to learn, not technical stuff. I want to give people this right to choose if you want to go to the professional level or you want to stop after first module. But within 3 days to learn how to do your own Feng Shui without to call a consultant. So I try to mix a little bit with the phase reading and the Feng Shui.
Mm-hmm.
Basic, but in order to help you. And after these 3 days, within a week, you can apply to your home. And after that, if you feel you want to go higher level, okay, then we can split phase reading to a professional way, Feng Shui the professional way. But that will be your choice. It's not like you have to do, you know, in Romania, for example, now if you study Feng Shui, you'll do level 1, level 2, level 3, level 4. I don't understand how they do these levels, but they say, you know, you have to wait like 3-4 years to apply this. Why? I don't want to go to the professional level. Maybe I just want to fix my home. So let the people choice to have this choice.
Exactly. Let them choose. Apply Feng Shui.
Yeah, this is what I intend to do this year. To do a class, for example, I don't know, maybe 3 or 4 days, we'll see. And after the 3 days, 4, we do a practical, 1 day just practice, just to see many homes. And after this, you'll take a week maybe to recap, to learn some stuff, and after that you can apply to your home. And after that, if you want to go higher, it's up to you. This is how I intend to do. And of course, I want to have a class. For example, I don't know how many will be to keep them like 3-4 years and to teach them everything. Because for me, it's very important to spread this knowledge. And because in Romania, this feng shui is so commercial. So I try to come with this classical feng shui, and I need few people to stay with me like 3-4 years to learn everything, to go together to houses, to everything, to just do together, and they will learn from the practice, not just the books, because the books is just the book.
It just scratches the surface.
Yeah, because on the practice you learn how to see. You cannot find everything in the book. The books teach you how to see, but you have to do a practice
to apply, to put it into practice,
to apply, because you'll find so many different cases. I mean, you'll see there are some pictures in the book, but you cannot find all these pictures in reality. Some of them, they are so different, some of them. So you have to see, and if you apply and you see, then you learn, and that is not in the books.
That's brilliant and truly amazing that you would like to also leave a legacy based on your experience, and you know, teach other people to follow this. I wish you good luck and for the future, and hopefully some of our members from Wellbeing enthusiast team will join you. I would love to also be part of one of these courses to learn more about it, because I've also read and learn how to learn on my own advantage all this let's say things that the nature provided me, so that use it on my own benefit.
Absolutely, very good.
Thank you again, Marius, very much for your time with us. We're looking forward to meet you again on your next seminars. I'm sure that our viewers and our subscribers for the Wellbeing podcast are looking forward to meet you again. We'll prepare a long list of questions so that you won't escape so easy. Have a lovely day and good luck with everything that you're doing.
Thank you very much.
Appreciate it.
Take care.
Thank you. Take care.